Our final inductee of 2004 comes to us from Germany. However, her husband has convinced her to spend some of her time in Las Vegas. Her astounding tennis career was punctuated in 1988, the Golden Grand Slam, when she won the four Grand Slams. She won all four Grand Slams, as well as a gold medal at the Seoul Olympics. She is the only player, male or female, to win all four majors at least four times. I'd like to ask you to please rise now for the German national anthem in honor of Steffi Graf. Thank you, and please be seated. To introduce Steffi today as a future Hall of Famer himself, he holds over 55 singles titles and a
Raymond James presents the ATP on Fox Sports Net. Today it's the final from Newport, Rhode Island, and the Campbell's Hall of Fame Tennis Championships, where Alexander Popp will face Greg Rusedski. But right now, folks, the ceremonies continue. Andre Agassi just about ready to introduce his wife, Steffi Graf. Let's go to the induction ceremonies right now.
Worthy to introduce the person that has changed my life. I realize the words have yet to be invented that are large enough, colorful enough, or true enough to express the heart and soul of this woman that I love. Stephanie. I wonder what can I possibly say to do justice to the way you've lived your life and the lives that you've changed. I began several years ago on a small chalkboard sitting in our kitchen, a tradition that I've carried on every night, that at the end of each day I have picked up the chalk and I've tried to express the many things you mean to me. Sometimes just a brief line, sometimes a short story, but always just the overflow from a grateful heart. And yet after these months and years of writing to each night, I've never been at a shortage of ways to reflect the light that you brought into my life. And now, how ironic that in these few short moments, I need to capture in words these things I so deeply appreciate in you. Maybe I can say it to you this simple way. Not long ago, we were on the road, and I looked out our hotel room window from the upper floor of a very tall high-rise. I could see the rooftop of an old and beautiful cathedral. It was stunning with its carved stone and marble all done so perfectly. I cannot believe the work of art I was seeing, and I wondered how many years did it take them to create this, and what drove them to be this committed. Then I began to appreciate something greater, I realized when this rooftop was built, it was by far the tallest building. And in an age long before airplanes or skyscrapers, these artists believed each day as they went about their work that no human being, no one set of eyes, would ever see their creation. How could they not have cut one corner? How could they consider no task routine? I can only think it came from a deep place inside. The need to be true to themselves was their reason and their reward. All of this has helped me to understand you just a little bit better. Never needing applause to be at your best. Only needing to give the best your soul could give to feel complete. From the roar of voices inside the lines of center court to the quietness of a child's bedroom. That generous soul, that unbending strength, that soft-spoken integrity has not one time been shaken. The arena of tennis simply gave you a platform and an opportunity to refine those inner qualities even more. You have always been about the action, not about the words. You have never defined yourself by what you have achieved. Rather, you have achieved by how you defined yourself. And even now, it has taken my breath away to see how you've quietly laid down your racket to pursue love and motherhood with the same zeal and high standards you have always demanded of yourself. No one has ever known you to be infatuated by your own accomplishments. In fact, as I have often said, anyone who speaks with you will most likely forget the great things you have done within 30 seconds. But they will feel cared for, their feelings engaged, and you never let go of their heart until that they know that they are completely understood. The history books will record for posterity your ability to embrace and rise above adversity, to play through injury, and to win again, again, and again. Far in the future, people will analyze and discuss your place as the greatest of your time. And as those future generations hear of your strength and dominance, they may be tempted to think that they know you or the real heart of a giant that beats inside of you. But for those of us who are blessed to actually see firsthand your quiet humility, to watch you represent your sport with unmistakable dignity, and for those of us who are even more blessed to be lifted out of ourselves by your laughter, to be on the receiving end of your always generous heart, we have etched forever in us something a statistic could never contain. We have been touched deeply by your life. You have made us better, and we will never be the same. Stephanie, you've spent many years of your life competing, but right here where we stand, in the ears of your children, and right now in my heart, you have no rival. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the greatest person I've ever known, Stephanie Graf.
Well, I can tell, I mean, oh, not that this occasion isn't emotional enough, but to hear that you loved so much is amazing. Yeah. Tennis has allowed me to get in this incredible journey. And the best part about this journey has been it led me to you. So. I'll be forever grateful for that. Okay, I'm gonna try now. I'm glad I get this podium to hold on to. Well, I want to thank all of you for coming out here today. It is great to look out and see so many friends and familiar faces here. It's an incredible, incredible honor. Yesterday, when we took a picture with members of the Hall of Fame, and as I looked around and I saw all these incredible, incredible champions, I mean, I felt so privileged and overwhelmed to be inducted here today. I want to thank the Enshrinement Committee for this honor. I want to also thank the Hall of Fame for allowing me this time to talk about some of the people that have made this possible. We're all defined by our relationships in our lives. Our accomplishments are the results of these relationships. I was blessed to have a great group of friends and family at my side during my career. I want them to know that this ceremony honors them as well. My family isn't as big as Dodo's, so don't worry. But nevertheless, extremely important. Dad, thank you for bringing tennis into my life and for teaching me the sport in a way that I could always strive to get the best I can. Your effort and commitment sent me on a wonderful journey that are still today going on. Thank you, Dad. Mom, what can I say about you? I mean, there's not enough time. Thank you for your support. You always gave me everything and beyond, everything I needed. Thank you for the inspiration you showed every day. Most of all, thank you for teaching me by your life how to care for a person's heart more than for their circumstance. Mike, my brother, you've been always my protector. You're the younger brother, but you always felt like you're the older to me. Thank you for giving me a platform to come out of my shell and explore life's challenges and for always, always, always looking out for me. I'd also like to thank my coaches and trainers. Some of them that can't be here today. One of my first coaches, Pavel, thank you for the time you gave me. Especially as a mother, I now appreciate even more how much you negotiated your world to commit so much to my career. Heinz, you are my coach on the court and my mentor off of it. You had the rare quality of understanding me better at times than I understood myself. However, what I appreciate most was your patient and sensitive way that allowed me to learn about life and myself. And the most important thing, you were the one that encouraged me to follow my heart with Andre. Tony, your work and insight were invaluable to the length of my quality of my career. You, as well as many trainers and doctors around the world, made it possible for me on the court to leave everything that I had. Thank you. And last, I would like to thank the fans who have supported me my whole career. Many of them that I see today in the stands, I mean, over a span of... and those that continue the passion that we all have, the passion for tennis. Thank you.
Steffi, your enshrinement certificate. Congratulations. Welcome to the International Tennis Hall of Fame. Congratulations. In keeping with tradition, I'd now like to ask the newest members of the International Tennis Hall of Fame to make a walk around the Bill Talbert Center court. So, John, if you would be kind enough to escort Dodo. We'll start around that way so all your fans can pay tribute to you. Stefan, if you would follow behind there, and Steffi, if you would follow behind.
Well, a very exciting day here at Center Court, the Bill Talbert Center Court, as we watch the three new inductees, Stefan Edberg, Steffi Graf, and already off and running, Dodo Cheney, escorted by John McEnroe. Leaf, certainly a very touching moment.
That really was. Some special words, John McEnroe introducing Dodo Cheney, the great senior champion. Tony Pickard, Stefan Edberg's longtime coach, saying so many touching words about his friend and pupil. And of course, Andre Agassi, a very moving speech, introducing his lovely wife, Steffi Graf.
I mean, this place has some different sounds, but when Andre started that introduction speech, telling Steffi how great she was and very well spoken, the place got very quiet.
Yeah, he was very profound in his feelings for her, her impression not only on tennis, but also on his life. And it was really touching and a very moving moment. And, you know, Barry, we've been through a number of these, and that was certainly one of the most special moments I've experienced on this court. And
no question.
No surprise that it's Andre Agassi. He always seems to come up with so many surprises.
The ultimate showman, and certainly put a big exclamation point on today's activities. McEnroe, of course, his usual jovial self, started things off by introducing Dodo Cheney, 347 national titles she has, and a huge hand for all of these inductees as they come around. Very, very exciting stuff here on the Bill Talbert Center Court. Hello, everybody. Barry McKay with you, along with Leif Shires. And what a day it's been. You can hear the roars behind us as these three inductees walk around. And a very special day, Leif.
It really is. Steffi Graf, just the third German in the hall after Gottfried von Kramm and Boris Becker, a very elite group there. And, of course, Stefan Edberg, just the fourth Swede inducted into the Hall of Fame. He joins a very elite group of Swedes, Bjorn Borg, Mats Wilander, and King Gustav. So that's a special moment for Stefan Edberg.
Standing ovation from a packed house here in Newport. This has been sold out for many, many weeks. Everybody looking forward to today's activities. And I was impressed by the Dodo Cheney group when she asked her family to stand up. There were virtually 50 people on that side that all stood up at the same time.
Yes, and what was so impressive was she had so many family members who were also tennis players and she had shared a similar kind of success, winning gold balls, which are symbolic of U.S. national titles. So Dodo Cheney, really one of the all-time greats.
Dodo Her daughter Christine, great player in her own right. She won a lot of mother and daughter titles, and I think McEnroe's kind of getting a kick out of this.
He really is.
Are you ready?
They're a bit of a mismatch there, but today they're just fellow Hall of Famers.
Exactly. That was very impressive. John got some interesting facts about Dodo, and I think she, in particular, appreciated his role in introducing her.
A number of dignitaries here. The governor of Rhode Island is in attendance, and many of the surrounding Hall of Famers are in attendance as well. This is the 50th anniversary of the Hall of Fame, so certainly a special moment.
Very special day. As we watch these three great players.